data before it, and it goes into one of the two things, either fear or greed, something which is easy, something which is a shortcut that attracts me, or something, as people said, we are fearful, we are about uncertainty, therefore people are not moving out of it. So either you are not ready to make the effort, or the fear, or the greed, and beautifully captured in Gita, in Arjun's state of mind, that when times are so critical, whether I have to fight my relatives and family or not, if Arjun, in Treta you had that difficulty, what is our difficulty in Kali Yuga? Ghor Kali Yuga. But if you want it, we can overcome it. I'll give you a few simple ideas. We became aware that I'm not a chartered accountant. I'm not an Indian. I'm not a Shubham or a Lapham or whatever, etc. I am this bundle of habits, feelings, likes, dislikes. And I have got used to a sense of entitlement. So many areas that I don't know. Can we get to a practice of gratitude? Can anyone here stand up and tell me that he's an extremely grateful person? You are grateful. Can I go on for a few minutes? Grateful. And keep expanding that list over 30 days. And if that list multiplies by 25 times during that period, right? Somebody will have one item. I have had so many people, if I ask them, what are you grateful about? They say, nahi, kuch khas nahi. Then some parents will come to mind, oh no, I think parents. It's not, it is serious. We are so self-obsessed, so full of entitlement, my own achievement, yaad bhi nahi aata. If that list multiplies by 25 times, I guarantee you, your life will change dramatically. There can't be a simpler idea. Why does that happen? Suddenly, you find, oh, there are so many bills to be paid. Maa baap ka kuch nahi kiya, friends ka nahi kiya, iska nahi kiya. Oh, kitne logon ne mere liye kiya. I won't go because I want you to enjoy. Whatever 2-5% because potential ki journey mein log chalte nahi hai, class mein kuch bhi ho jaye, hall mein kuch bhi ho jaye, people go out, have lunch and forget it. So over the last 40 years, I know that not more than 5 or 10% of the people in any given classroom will go and really change their life. If the statistics is wrong in this class, great, it'll be great for all of you. You're now very conscious of what is the situation on the other side. So that's number one. Number two, first we started with tapa, effort. Third, this Ram business, Ram Maryada Ram, he also in his weak moment slipped. And we don't even notice it, right? Unless someone thinks deeply about it. How alert are you about your actions and what is affecting your mind? Is whether it is demonstration effect or just like that. And one practice out of that. So India is full of all these principles. We just don't take it as practical. Go to theek hai, dharm mein jayega, sadhu banega to karna hai. One of these yama, yam and niyam are well known, right? Satya, ahimsa, asteya, brahmacharya, etc. Only one I am asking you to take most seriously. And you won't guess that. Which of that is the most powerful, most essential of the five? Satya. If Satya is not there, everything else is zero. I have created a foundation, Satya Vigyan Foundation, that in a country which calls itself, which has this motto as Satyamev Jayate, 99% people sitting in this hall wouldn't know the precise meaning of the word expression Satyamev Jayate. Sorry? No, sir. It does not say truth prevails all the time. Yes?
Truth only triumphs.
Sorry?
Truth only triumphs.
Truth only triumphs. And what are we all professionals trying to do? Make false and adopt truth. Next, of course, is being alert. Beautiful bhajan. So, jagrit rehna re, Which is the chore that comes? Your thoughts, your feelings. And lastly, without serious surgery, things cannot change. Your mind needs surgery. So we had upvas as one thing, right? So people fasted on Ekadashi, Jains on Ashtami, Chaturdashi. Every third day was a day of fast. Now that fast has not gone out of our life. But something else has come. Intermittent fasting has come. So intermittent fasting, our focus is on health. It's not on spiritual well-being. Ideally, I would have liked 10 more minutes to give you an experience about everything it experiences. Bina matlab ke. You see somebody, achha dikh raha hai. Achha nahi dikh raha hai. No reason. Just like that. Here I kept giving you instruction, accept the breath as it is. At least for a few moments, your mind was not in the hyper-judgmental mood. The habit of not getting into hyper-judgmental mode is the primary quality of a manager. Right? When two people have a dispute, they go to the manager and the manager says, apni baat batao, apni baat batao. He is not into judgmental. People who go with the dispute have this judgment, this is wrong and this is wrong. But he says he listens. The judge listens. A witness is valuable because he does not judge. No decisions can be taken in this world in majority of the cases unless somebody learned to be someone was a witness. Judge took sides, he will not be a judge. But in our own life, because of these habits of entitlement, etc., etc., we are so used to making judgments which weaken our mind, which make our mind extremely restless, and therefore very incapable of taking judgments, particularly in tough times. The last thing, I guess, abhi tak to koi kisi bhi practice only learning to observe our breath, concentrating our mind, and magical things start happening. My friends, this simple exercise you can download from internet. This is called Anapan by S.N. Goenka. Government of Maharashtra has made this compulsory in Maharashtra. All the schools are teaching Anapan 10 minutes in the morning, 10 minutes before they go home. You can adopt this as a practice in your life. I guarantee you it will give you peace. It will give you the ability to do whatever practice that will connect you to your core as you become first that great